With the satellite back online, the full scale and origin of the attack is revealed. Olivia Pierce, the Lazarus Project's lead scientist turned cult leader, activated a hellwave and released hundreds of demons from their holding cells in the Lazarus laboratories. The devastations that followed have left this facility on the brink of complete destruction. The Foundry reactors are in critical meltdown. Samuel Hayden, a survivor and head of the Mars facility, has offered you his help if you need it. You don't. You just need ammo and a way to stop the meltdown before it tears the base right the fuck apart. Welcome to Level 3 Meltdown of Doom. Oh yeah. Stop that meltdown.
After running more diagnostics on the active freighter suit, it appears that I can accelerate the upgrading of your arsenal by measuring your combat effectiveness. I have added a tracker to your helmet's display.
Weapon upgrade. The facility will not allow you access to the turbine room unless the demonic threat level is brought down inside the foundry. Our security systems cannot be overridden.
In other words, you have to kill shit. Nice jump, dick face. We got like all kinds of shit going on here in the foundry. Doesn't look good. Oh yeah, he's getting on it. Well, he was getting on it. Foundry Team Manifest. Congratulations, new advocate. If you're reading this message, you've been promoted to the Foundry Resource Team. If you are volunteered for this service and you are joining the elite band of Tier 1 advocates whose work and dedication keeps our mission running on all cylinders. As a member of the Foundry Resources, you'll have access to some of the most advanced equipment the UAC has to offer, including Gripton cargo hold handlers and Delta V jump boots and dino-phasic elevators and all kinds of crazy shit. New members might want to consider applying for an exclusive team tattoo upon joining as a sign of their faith in all science. Team tattoos are a mark of your tireless work at the UAC and can be requested by signing up for any of the Lazarus Wave case studies. Please contact a Tier 3 Advanced Weaponry Technician to fill in your application for a Pentagram brand today. Yeah. Argent Energy. Early in the development of the Argent Accumulator, it was discovered that the Argent Plasma compressed into Hayden radius spheres named after Samuel Hayden would retain its structure when charged with enough radioactive isotopes. Once formed, it's the surface tension of the plasma sphere is broken. The energy cache contained within will quickly discharge, energizing anything it comes into contact with. Argent caches were the forerunner of the Argent Accumulator, but their vulnerability to blunt force makes them their use too unpredictable. There are still hundreds of these prototype Argent caches to be found around the Argent facility and have been somewhat of a collector's item among UAC employees. I know all about the weapon switching, thank you. Thank you very much. We need to unlock the machine gun, although we can get superheated rounds. Ah, I see. Yeah, why not? Ah! You know I knew that micro-missile, man. Gotta have the micro-missile. Multi-chambered cylinder located under the primary barrel can be loaded up to 6 HMX missiles. Small but deadly rockets were designed to deliver multiple payloads to a single target. It can also be used to subdue multiple targets within a tight kill zone. The missiles will detonate shortly after making contact with any surface. Yeah, better micro-missiles. That dude made him his bitch.
Access denied.
Well, ain't that some shit? Challenges: kill 3 of the possessed with 1 explosive barrel. Perform 3 death from above glory kills on possessed. And find 2 collectibles. I'll take that, thank you very much. We like Predator tokens. I don't know if that's so great. When a power-up wears off, a damaging blaster is released. Upon activating a power-up, health will be filled to maximum. Those aren't too bad. Those can be helpful, I'm assuming. Yeah, we want stock up. Now we can throw multiple grenades, baby! And that's what the fuck I'm talking about. Welcome to the Grenade Ghetto! Now to do a bit of climbing. Hello. Oh, I'll need that. Fuck you. Taking your heart, bitch! Got us some new demons in the house. I don't know if I'm gonna get any of these challenges.
Demon threat reduced by 25%.
But we will claim all the collectibles. No doubt about it, baby! Warning, core heat level at maximum threshold. That's alright, we'll take care of that. Trying to curb stomp him. Need to get some leverage though. Some elevation. I don't think we want to fall down there. Motherfucker! You got smoke, bitches! Motherfucker! Backbreaker! I'll take that. I don't think you'll be needing it. Spokesperson talking that shit. Whoa, that's the wrong gun.
Oh shit! Fuck you!
Weapon upgrade point for just smashing face in, baby. The game hoarder does that shit. Not so interested in my pistola. As good as she treats me. Hello, little guy.
Warning, core temperature rising.
Flip the switch. And let's open up a classic map. Oops. That was a bad jump, sir. A very bad jump.
Warning. Core temperature.
Let's try that again. Without jumping down to perilous lake of lava. That's better. Got that one challenge. Blowing up multiple fuck nuts with one barrel. Holy shit and piss! You got fucked up, big guy! The Game Hoarder welcoming you to the ghetto. Wave makes for a great follow-up.
Warning,
That was fun. Now back to reality. A couple more gore nests to fucking destroy here. Get out of my face, asshole. You know we want some of this. Oh yeah. More health. Always focused and committed. I'm the fucking game hoarder. Born into a wealthy and powerful Hayden family, he completed his master's in theoretical physics at Oxford University. He showed prodigious talent in several fields, including thermodynamic, electromagnetic theory, and nuclear sciences. At a young age, he established the Samuel Hayden Foundation, philanthropic organization dedicated to sponsoring young scientific talent and funding scientific programs in schools and colleges. His daunting intellect made him prime target for the UAC, and they recruited him soon after he was appointed general director of the Global Science Council. Samuel took over leadership of UAC a few months after the discovery of the Argent Fracture and immediately put the Argent Tower into production. During the construction of the Argent Tower, Samuel was diagnosed with stage 4 inoperable brain cancer. He was given 6 months to live. He dedicated those last few months to finding a radical solution to his mortality, a cybernetic transference. Pretty impressive. Hell Knight. Hell Knight is a towering brute bred for combat deep in the bowels of hell. These diabolical beasts are all the prized gladiators of the demon horde. They relentlessly stomp towards their target, smashing their massive fist into the ground to create shockwaves that stagger their opponent and leave them vulnerable to bone-crushing melee attacks. The Hell Knight's powerful legs allow it to leap across large distances effortlessly, quickly closing the gap to its enemy. Also, the Hellraiser, an astute and tactical foe that will engage enemies from a distance with a powerful beam of unrefined hell energy. The beam emanates from an arm-like protrusion composed of cartilage and other osseous tissue. Articulation of the cartilage allows the Hellraiser to focus its energy beam into a single charge shot that will obliterate anything that stands in its motherfucking path. Can you say 5 points? Oh yeah. You know. Get a direct hit with an explosive shot will spawn cluster bombs and deal the damage. So, just need to get 20 direct hits on imps. Their explosive shot. That's why you want to kind of unlock those as early as you can.
Remember, the Blind Council is always watching.
Fuck you.
Stay focused. Stay committed.
That's some bullshit. Get some! Get some!
The Council is always watching.
We don't fucking know that.
Core temperature rising.
I love these fucking grenades, man. I can't wait to max this shit out. Make some cluster bombs. Cluster fuckage. Think you want to go through there. I'll take that. Leaves us with one more secret, one more lead guard, and curb stomping, which we haven't done any of. Nor would I go out of my way to do. Well, might as well rip this fucking thing out. That'll be like a direct hit. That didn't work. Sweep the leg, Johnny! Shit, curb stomped himself with his own foot. Fuck you. Ah. Gore nested, got gored.
Demonic threat reduced by 50%.
Shotgun shells, we need those. Very important. Stay on top of our shotgun game. Yes. Yes. The game order is pleased with this game. Okay. Couldn't tell if that was it looked like heavy machine gun shit. Blue key card. Not fucking around with that guy. $420
With you, we will
fuck him
and move humanity into the future.
Oh, diagnostic time. All right, got that hit point.
Have you filled out your UAC accidental data?
The UACL station follows the same standard design specifications as its predecessor, the Health Pack, but with improved nanobot dispersal and faster cellular analysis. When the patient's arm is inserted in the administration sleeve, I thought that said administration. The Health Station initiates a microscopic atomic force scan on the subject of the administrators of nanobot package that targets cellular deficiencies. Chem clusters are then dosed to the patient, which stimulates rapid recovery. Some users experience lightheadedness when using the Health Station. This can be cured by reinserting the patient's arm into the machine and running it a second time. This step can be repeated as often as necessary. Okay. What else was I missing there? The Foundry, an extension wing of the Resource Operations, the first Mars outpost, processes all the heavy elements mined from the outlying Martian landscape and from all the original location of the Argent Fracture. Refining Argent plasma requires a large amount of transitional metals and noble gases, so a central location that can be systematically cleansed and decontaminated is required to keep Argent energy production at maximum efficiency. As such, this area is considered a high-risk area, and all UAC employees are subject to regular med checks to ensure that production capabilities are not degraded by the environment. Industrial accident-related deaths in the Foundry dropped dramatically in MTC 2146 thanks to the implementation of the new UAC safety protocols, where employees exposed to dangerous materials are immediately sent to the Lazarus Labs for cleansing, re-education, and where possible, reintegration. As a result of this protocol, officially reported deaths have dropped to negligible amounts. I wonder why. Gordas time. Right? About the Gordas, money cash hoes.
Success. With you, we will establish a new era and move humanity into the future. You filled out our UAC accidental death and dismemberment form. See Jessica and Human Resources.
Sorry! That's a direct hit. Holy fuck my balls! Gotcha, you big fucker! Wanted to chainsaw one of them bitches badly.
Reduced by 75%.
Oh, fuck!
See Jessica and Human Resources for assistance.
Good night, sweetheart.
The devotion to the UAC's mission on Mars is the foundation of our success.
That was probably another good place to get the achievement for multiple people with one barrel. That was ironic. The Imp 2. More status on the Imps. Despite their low status among the demon ranks and their seemingly endless numbers, Imps have unique characteristics in battle. Some prefer fighting from an elevated position, while others will rush their target and swipe at them with razor-sharp claws. Walls and obstacles offer no defense against Imps as they leap great heights and easily hang from the surfaces. The Imp is capable of channeling hell energy through its hands and shaping it into a projectile. As the Imp channels the energy, airborne particles and debris are sucked into the maelstrom to create a condensed, superheated fireball. The mechanics of the Imp's ranged attack suggest that they are actually a lower form of the Summoner. I don't know if we want to meet this so-called Summoner. Booyah! I like rocket launchers, don't you? The weapon has seen little design modification since its development in the late 21st century. It's a standard issue to heavy weapon specialists in all military forces due to its unparalleled direct impact and radius damage. The UAC provides the design slightly by adding... improved the design slightly by adding an automated quick reload. The weapon casing has been retrofitted to accept UAC developed modifications. Motherfucker. Now we just need to unlock some shit for it. 8 out of 20 for our mastery challenge there. And we need a field drone mod to unlock our missile launcher. Don't think we want to use that in confined spaces, though. I don't know what you're laughing about, dickface. You're about to get fucked up! Thank you very much, Nancy Pants. Shit, that should have counted as two. Kick you right in your ass.
Demon presence reduced to minimum save levels. Lockdown disengaged. Turbine room doors now open.
Whoa, dude! Fucking hard to hit guys with that shit. Jesus. Fuck you, dude! Micro missile on a bitch. You bitch! There's one! My first jump curb stop. Oh shit! Big Daddy Kane! Fuck it! Good. That means I can get the fuck out of here, right?
A primary control room has been activated somewhere nearby. It could be Olivia.
And this will be the last collectible of the level. The last Praetor Soup upgrade. All right.
We're at 5 on our weapons. Might as well get something going here. Heat blast for the plasma. Generate heat passively without needing to spend ammo. That's kind of cool. Machine gun, though. Yeah, let's go with this. Hey, bitch. Wanna fuck?
Olivia Pierce. Alpha 4-0-2.
She is trying to tear open the portal between our world and theirs.
That's not good. I've been to fucking hell too many times. I don't need it coming here. Whoever here is.
You could not have saved them anyway.
They need to make more of these. These are good fucking dooms. What would be fucking sick is if they remade Doom 1 and 2 with these graphics. That would be fucking worthy of some game ordering.
System won't allow anyone but Olivia to override it now. We will have to shut down the Argent Tower manually from the surface.
No problem. See you there. And I'll see you fucking folks next time with some more motherfucking doom. Looks like I didn't get any curb stompage, but we annihilated the exploration part of the game. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, tell me how much you love the fucking Game Hoarder and his ghetto.